Hi guys, I thought we'd do something a bit different today, and I've not seen anybody else do this on YouTube or elsewhere, so this could be a first, who knows. What I'd like to talk to you about today is where can we find information to help us when we're wanting to repair things, yeah? So we're interested in schematic diagrams, data sheets for components, internet forums, advice, and that sort of website. And where are they? That's, you know, where do you find this information? Well, you might be surprised, but I'm sure you will not be surprised, that the first place to go and look for information is Google. Yeah, Google. So in here we can search, for example, like motherboard schematics, yeah, and we see what we can find. There's one here, we'll have this one, yeah, Linus Tech Tips, that's well known, from April 2019. So this is one of those sites. So somebody here asking, they figured this community would know a thing or two about computers. Is there any possible way, website, manual, to find schematic layout for motherboards? Yeah, I want to do some homework on my own motherboard through MSI and I can't find the solution. Where are the schematics? Answer, go and work at MSI. These things are not released to the public. I thought that might be the case. Can I effectively work the layout myself, reverse engineer? Probably not, unless you've got a lot of experience. Vladimir asking again. This guy's mentioning surface map components give more chances. He's suggesting that use the data sheets from the components, which is what you've seen me do, yeah? And we just carry on. Somebody says he's got quite a few schematics on his server. And that's it. So basically, the main answer is that go and work for the company because these are not available. And that's for MSI, yeah? Well, yeah, thanks Linus, but to be quite honest, I know it's not you answering, but that isn't strictly speaking true, to be honest. There's a good example I'm just going to show you now. This is on my hard drive where I keep some schematics, motherboard, yeah, desktop, MSI. And look, you can see I've got a hell of a lot of schematics. I don't know how many thousand folders are. This is just the MSI properties. I've got 1.32 gigabytes, 983 files and 213 folders. So I've got about 1,000 schematics there for MSI. So yeah, Linus, whoever was on your site, they were wrong. So right, where do they come from? Hey, where do they come from? Well, I'll tell you where they come from. The most common place I go to if I'm looking for a schematic, I'll go into Google and I'll type the model of the motherboard and schematic and see if it actually finds me what I'm looking for, and occasionally it will, but I'm more likely to look in one of two places, and the first one is this forum called Bad Caps. Yeah, Bad Caps forum. So let's make a note of this. One, Google, first place to look for anything, Google, yeah. I used to be able to write really good until I started using computers all the time. Two, badcaps.net. This is a free forum you can join. Very popular. There are, I don't know how many members on here. 353, nearly 354,000 members on here, yeah. Very popular site, been there for about 20 years. And this is where I look for stuff. So if I want schematics, you'll find them in here. Desktop motherboards and graphics cards, yeah? BIOS and schematic requests. Go in here, yeah, and do a search on the forum for the one you want. If you can't find it, post in here, new thread, and ask for your schematic. That's where I get a lot of schematics from. I have a similar thing, the same in laptops, yeah, so laptops, schematic requests. This is where you, if you want a schematic for a laptop, you can go and search, yeah, put the model number in there. If you don't find it, new thread and ask. This forum's completely free. You have to register, but it's free, yeah, no credit card, no nothing. So Bad Caps is the place I go to, number one, for schematics. Badcaps.net, I've written that down. Also, while you're in here, this is also the place I go for repair advice. We have all sorts of sections in here. I'm a regular member, I'm a regular contributor on here. You'll see me posting a lot on here, helping other people, and you will see me asking for advice. You know, I don't know everything, nobody else knows everything, we all help each other, yeah. But you can assure it that if somebody knows, if you ask on here, you'll get it. So I'll just show you, like troubleshooting desktops. People with GTX 1070 won't boot. Need a schematic for an ASRock, that's in the wrong place. Power King, all sorts of things, different things, yeah. People are here asking questions, like you know, ASUS B85E takes too long to boot and such like. So you'll find me a lot in there, in particular. Laptops sometimes, if I'm repairing laptops. And other equipment, audio equipment, you can ask, you know, games consoles. Just general questions, how to solder, how should I do this, how should I do that. General electronics discussion, can you recognise this component, and so on. So, I recommend, if you're not a member, and I'm no affiliate to this forum, I don't get anything for recommending this. If you're not a member, badcaps.net, just join there, yeah. Get in there, post in the announcements, hi, I'm a new member. And that's it, yeah, get in there. So that's what that one. Right, where else do I go on the internet? The next one for schematics is a site called Schematic X, yeah? This is a free website. Schematic X, okay? Schematic X, schematic downloads. And here you have lots of schematics for different makes of motherboard. This is really desktop motherboard site, yeah? It's schematic downloads. It says laptops. I haven't looked. Maybe yeah, laptops as well, but I use this with PC motherboards. So, example, Acer schematics. Only we have many schematics available. It's not so good for the latest motherboards, but this is a great place to look if you have to a schematic. Yeah, I'm just scrolling down and down and down. Again, you can search, you can ask on here, but I'm not, don't think he's very active, this guy. I'm not sure he's putting a lot of new stuff on. But you can do a search, control F, type in a model number, and you'll see, you know, if we can find something, you'll find it in there, yeah. So, okay, that's Schematic X. So let's make a note of that one. Yeah. Okay, next place I'd probably look for schematics in particular is EVEblog. Now, EVEblog is another forum, EEVBLOG. This has been around, I don't know, more than 10 years, I would say. This is an electronics forum, to be quite honest. No, I'm not on that, that's the .com. Let me find the forum. EVEblog forum. Okay. And the same with Bad Caps forum. Search for Google for Bad Caps forum, because they also have a homepage, yeah? That's the one you want. So in here, EVEblog community forum. You'll find me on here. I'm not a regular poster on here, but this is basically the electronics forum. So, talk about test equipment, soldering methods, but it does have a section for repair, yeah? Just the one section for repair, and this is a place worth going and asking people on all sorts of things. Look, you see today, how many posts, that's just today, yesterday. So, you know, it's an active forum, and you can go and ask for repair advice on here. Personally, I am on Bad Caps, but sometimes I'm on here. I've been invited to join a discussion on here, which when somebody knows I'm posting on Bad Caps, says, can you come and join in? I've got, you know, a similar discussion on here. So yeah, that's another good one. So we'll look at that one. And this is great if you want to learn more about components and electronics. EVEblog forum, yeah? It's free, again, register, but it's free. So that's that one. After those four, the next place you're likely to find me on the internet, strange enough, is YouTube. Yeah, you know, obviously I have a YouTube channel now, which I'm enjoying. But YouTube, I'm usually on here if I want to know how to take something apart. That's the most common one on here. So, like, if I want, like, a Samsung tablet, you can put dismantle, but a lot of people put tear down. I'd never even heard this word until a year or so ago. Tear down, take apart, yeah? If you want to know how to take something apart, this is a great place to do it. Because quite often with things like this, you can't figure out how to get into the damn things, yeah? I use that one mainly. Sometimes if I want to know how to solder a certain type of components, I'll come on here as well. So if I'm going to like something like a QFN desolder, I wonder how we could see how is best to desolder that or solder a type of chip, yeah? So that's what I use YouTube for. It's surprisingly useful. I mean, everybody knows YouTube, but maybe you didn't think about using it for looking at repair, apart from that's where you found me. Okay, so teaching to suck some eggs there, YouTube. Other place, yeah, another place you'll commonly find me. This is not a repair forum, but this is where if I've got stupid things going on, like a computer doesn't recognize a hard drive like I had the other day, or something going on that I suspect is probably more software related than hardware related, and that's a website called Bleeping Computer. I'm sure there's other, there must be others, but I use this one really if I want to know. And we once again we go to forums, yeah, and this is where really anything I think software and sometimes hardware related, if I want to know about internal hardware. It's not a repair forum, not a component level repair forum, but there's a hell of a lot of useful information on here. So that's a great resource, especially if it's on computers you think it's software or software related or firmware related. So that's that one. So that's number six. Bleeping Computer, yeah? So that's where I go for software. What else do I have? Facebook. Don't use Facebook much for this. In fact, I don't like Facebook. I do my best to stay off Facebook. I'll go off there for months on end, and then I might appear for a week or two, and then just go off for months on end again. But there is repair support groups on there. There's one called, I think it's called Console Repair Legion. Game Console Repair Legion. This is one that I found. They're on YouTube as well. Okay, that's a useful one. I'll remember that. But they're on Facebook, yeah? It's going to ask me to log in. Yeah, it's a private group. 14.2 million members. I'm in this group. If I'm logged in on my Facebook account, I'm in here, yeah? So, Console Repair Legion. Yeah, also on YouTube apparently. I'll have to look at their channel, I haven't looked at it. That's a useful one, obviously, if you're doing consoles. Right, where else do I go? There's another one that I sometimes use. I don't use this very often, and I'll use this often because I do a search on Google for a schematic and it points me to this site, yeah? And this is Electro Tanya. Okay. Electro Tanya, service manual finder, yeah? This is not an English website. This is, I think it's Czech. Somebody's going to tell me what this language is. I think it's Czech. But you can kind of find your way around it. And what you're often seeing, like, people asking, like, that's in English, that one, yeah? Monitor sometimes doesn't run. So this is quite useful for general repair work, and quite often I've downloaded schematics from here, especially things like audio amplifiers, power amplifiers, DJ equipment, you know, PA systems, that sort of thing. So that's a place worth keeping in mind. I don't go there very often, but sometimes they have something you can't find anywhere else, yeah? Electro Tanya, number 8, number 9. I don't think we're going to make it to 10. Number 9. There's a few websites, there's more than a few, no, there's probably a handful of sites, where you can get schematics, but they pay sites. You may pay like €4 or something for a free trial, and you can download up to 20 schematics. You may pay about €10 a month, or you know, 20, 30 euros for 6 months, that sort of thing. Some people dislike the whole thing of pay sites. The only thing I've got against them is that, I mean, I don't object to anybody making money for what they're doing, you know, but these pay sites do not own the copyright or intellectual property. They don't own that IP, intellectual property. They don't own the rights. This is stuff that's been sneaked out of companies, stolen, whatever. And to be quite honest, all these schematics for computers really have. Many of them you're looking on them, they say, you know, company secrets and that sort of thing on them. So these people, one way or another, getting these schematics for nothing and then selling them to you. So once you get past that moral thing, and you can accept that, then you have to realise that sometimes you need that schematic, yeah? You need it. And if they've got it, and you can get on there for the month and pay €10 for the month, and while you're at it, grab as many other schematics as you can before you hit your limit, then you should do so. There's only two pay sites I've used. This is one of them, VinerFX. I went on here for a month or two. I'm not a member at the moment. I'm a member, but I'm not a paid member at the moment. These are good for getting up to date schematics often. You can see they've put all those just on in the last 20 minutes, yeah? View more. All these today, yeah? Today. So you see, this is getting updated very regularly. How much is the cost of this one? Let me see, I can't remember. It's VIP. It's €4 for a day. It's 20 for a month, yeah? When I wanted something, rather than paying the four, and you can pay with PayPal, so it's, you know, it's safe. This one here, you can download 30 downloads a day, yeah, for 30 days, which is 900 schematics for $20, yeah. If you need the schematic and that $20 is going to fix something for you that you couldn't otherwise fix, it's got to be worth it, don't you think? So whatever you think about pay sites, that's it, yeah. They do a few other options as well. $9.99 for 1 week and 20 downloads. There's 840 downloads for $10, that sort of thing, yeah? Okay, so that's VinerFX. And that's about it. There are a few other pay sites, laptop schematics and some other ones. You'll never find any site that's got everything on. At the end of the day, you'll not find a site that actually has everything on that you want. You'll only find sites that have got some things that you want, yeah? And that's it. So I don't think anybody's done this before. Those are the places I go. This is the place you'll most often find me. And if you're trying to fix a motherboard and graphics, or a graphics card, the desktop one, and you post a question on there in the desktop motherboards and graphics repair section, there's a very good chance that one of the guys answering you will be me, yeah? This one you don't see me very often, but it's a very good electronics forum. I can't say I think I've said everything that can be said about that, really. So there you go, that's where I go. Very interested again in your guys' comments, what you think. Please suggest other good sites, especially free sites. And I'll see you on the next video. Cheers now.